Hi everyone! Welcome to this video on getting started with the Syncfusion File Manager component in a Blazor WebAssembly application. In this video, I'll explain how to create a Blazor WebAssembly application and add the Syncfusion Blazor package to it. Then I will show you how to add the Syncfusion Blazor File Manager component to the Blazor WebAssembly application. After creating a file manager component, I will show you how to perform file operations using server-side physical file provider codes. In this video, I will create a Blazor WebAssembly application, along with an ASP.NET Core backend project, using Visual Studio 2019. This way, I can explain the client-to-server file managing concepts. You can watch a descriptive video on Blazor and Syncfusion components which I have shared in the YouTube card. Using Visual Studio 2019, create a new project. Select the Blazor app template, enter the project name, My Blazor App, and click Create. Select the Blazor WebAssembly app template and the option ASP.NET Core Hosted. Visual Studio will generate a server-side project that uses the ASP.NET Core backend and configure the WebAssembly app to it. Proceed by clicking the Create button. Now, Visual Studio has generated a Blazor WebAssembly application, a client project, along with an ASP.NET Core backend project and a shared project for model declaration. To use Syncfusion Blazor components, you need to install the Syncfusion.blazor NuGet package in my application. To do that, open the NuGet package manager by right-clicking the project file and selecting Manage NuGet Packages. Under the Browse tab, search for the Syncfusion.blazor package. Select it and click the Install button. The installation is completed now. You can check the Dependencies folder and the Packages folder, and you will find the Syncfusion.blazor package added to this application. From version 18.4.0.30, you can use the package Syncfusion.blazor.fileManager, an individual package that contains only file manager related assemblies alone. Next, the Syncfusion Blazor service must be registered in the services collection. For that, open the program.cs file and use the Syncfusion.blazor namespace. Within the main method, make a call to the addSyncfusionBlazor method. This makes Syncfusion Blazor services available within the application. Next, I must register a valid Syncfusion license key. To do so, in the first line of the main method, call the Syncfusion Licensing Syncfusion License Provider class, static method, register license. You also need to pass your Syncfusion license key as a string parameter in the register license method. I have done this off screen. Within the root folder, open the index.html file. Within the head tag, add the required CSS file to render the Syncfusion Blazor components. In this example, I reference the CSS file from the installed Syncfusion Blazor package. Next, let me add the Syncfusion Blazor file manager to the index component. To do so, use the Syncfusion.blazor.fileManager namespace. Adding this namespace here will allow me to use the file manager component markup in this index component. Also, you can import this namespace in the imports.razor page to make it available in all the Razor components within this application. Remove the existing code and type the SF file manager tag. Now I am going to write code to do file operations on the server side. To do so, within the SF file manager tag, add the file manager AJAX settings tag, so that an AJAX request will be sent to the server, which then processes the request and sends back the response. Within it, add the URL property and set the URL as api/file-manager/file-operations, where file-operations is the server-side action method to perform file actions like read, delete, copy, move, get details, search, rename, and create a new folder. Next, I will define this file-operation method on the server side. For that, in the server project, create an empty MVC controller class and name it File Manager Controller. Let me add the root API/controller to identify the right method while calling action methods from the client side. Remove the existing code and add a string object base path to store the content root path of this application, that is, the server machine's content root path. Create a constructor and receive the iWebHost environment object within it. Assign this class's base path object with the hosting environment object's content root path property. Now create a public object method file operations, and receive the parameter of type file manager directory content. As I mentioned earlier, file manager supports multiple file operations. So, within this method, add code to perform those operations, a case for read, delete, copy, move, details, create, search, and rename. Here, you can see a variable named operation that does all file management calls. I need to import the namespace for the class file manager directory content. To do so, open the online user guide documentation. In the Getting Started page, under the topic, initialize the service in controller, click the link provided so that you can download the files related to the physical file provider class, the class that contains the implementations for these file management operations. Open the zip file, and you can see the physical file provider and its base class files. Copy these files, and within my server project, create a folder named models, and paste those files into it. Also, copy and paste a data folder in the server project path that has a subfolder and files within it. This way, I can explain file operations using the file manager component in the server side. In Visual Studio, you can see the files inside the models folder and the data folder with its subfolder and files. Now you can import the needed namespace for the file manager directory content class. Next, declare and initialize this operations object. Import the namespace Syncfusion EJ2 file manager physical file provider, and within the controller class, create a variable of type physical file provider named operation. In the constructor, assign the operation variable with a new physical file provider object and set the root folder for this physical file provider using base path and the path data/files. Remember, I have already pasted the folder data and the subfolder named files with many subfolders and files in the server project path. Let me add the root file operations. Now let us see how this code works. Save the file and run the application. You can see the file folder and its subfolders with files. You can go to the toolbar for direct access to file operations. There's a navigation pane for easy navigation among folders and a breadcrumb for parent folder navigations. Click on the view button. You can see the file manager items in large icons and in details view. Right-click on the view, and you can see the context menu with options like sort, view, and refresh. You can perform multiple file selections too. When you select a folder and right-click, the context menu opens with folder-related options. You can search items using this search text box. It checks all the subfolders and brings out the result. You can do operations like creating a new folder. So, let me create a new folder and name it test. You can see the same folder created in the server path. Now, click the delete button and it asks for confirmation and choose yes. You can see the same folder deleted from the server. Select the document file and click the download button. It shows a 415 error. This is because I didn't implement code for this download operation. Let me do that now. In the File Manager Ajax settings tag, add the download URL property and set the value /api/file manager/download. Next, implement this download method on the server side. In the File Manager Controller class, add a public method of the return type iActionResult download with a string parameter. The parameter is of string type because the selected list of files and folders to be downloaded were serialized to the string format. The file manager will serialize the file manager directory content into string format and send it to the server. To take the list of files and folders that were serialized, first I need to deserialize it. So, declare an object of type file manager directory content and assign it by calling the JSON convert deserialize object. Set the type as file manager directory content and pass the parameter variable. Return the operation download method value by passing the path and names of the content object. Let me add the root download. Now, let's see how this works. Save the file and run the application. Select the sample document file and click download. The file was downloaded successfully. Next, let me show you how to manage file uploads from client to server using the file manager component. To make upload operations work, in the File Manager Ajax settings tag, add the upload URL property and assign the value API/file manager/upload. Implement this upload method on the server side. In the File Manager Controller class, add a public method of the return type, iActionResult, upload, and receive three parameters, path of string type, that holds the current path of the file to be uploaded, upload files, of type list of iForm file, that holds the file names to be uploaded, and action of type string, that contains the action name. Here, save will be the action. Let me add the code to upload. I have created an object of type, file manager response, which returns the response to the file manager with success or failure. I have called the operation object's upload method by passing the path, upload files, and action. Also, added code to return the error information if any error occurs. Add the root as upload. Save the file and run the application. Click the upload button and select a file. The file is uploaded successfully to the server folder. You can see this in the File Explorer in the Server Application folder. Next, let me open the Pictures folder to see the images. You can see that there is no preview scene for the images. Let me add code to see the previews for these images. In the File Manager Ajax Settings tag, add the GetImageURL property and assign the value API/FileManager/GetImage. Implement the GetImage method on the server side. In the File Manager Controller class, add a public method of the return type, iActionResult, GetImage, and receive the parameter of type, File Manager Directory Content. Return the operation object's GetImage method by passing the path object that contains the current path of the image file. Other parameter values are optional. So, I pass the default values, null and false. This method will return the file stream result object for each image present in the folder. Add the root, GetImage. Save the file and run the application. Open the Pictures and Employees folder, and now you can see the image previews in the File Manager. That's it. Finally, let me summarize the main points. I explained the steps to create a Blazor application and add the Syncfusion Blazor package. Then I showed you how to add the Syncfusion Blazor File Manager component to the Blazor WebAssembly application. Then I showed you how to perform file operations using server-side physical file provider codes, download a file, upload a file, and show image previews in File Manager. You can download this working example from the GitHub link in the video description below. You can also check if you're eligible for our community license, which gives you a free license key to use our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, click the like button and subscribe to our channel to get notifications about new videos. Thanks for watching.